हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड्स आई एम ज्योति विद पवन कुमार। फ्रेंड्स, द होल वर्ल्ड इज पासिंग थ्रू ए वेरी डिफिकल्ट टाइम एट द मोमेंट एंड लुकिंग अराउंड आई फील पर्सनली दैट द सिचुएशन could have been much in control provided the authorities, the government took right steps in time and realized their responsibility. The governments can do a lot for the welfare of the people, especially in times like this, but no. It's quite evident they are not doing what they are supposed to. So what happened? Like last year, the workers, they have fled to their homes, daily wages workers, because they were not given assurance that the authorities of the government will look after them, will provide them, and will not let them suffer as they did last time. So the result is that yesterday I rang up, I needed some medicines, and I rang up a chemist, and he was not picking my phone. Then I tried another one, and the same thing happening at most of the places. Then I found out the reason. The reason is because all these people, they don't have many workers in their shops. Only some places, only one person is handling. So they are unable to answer the phone calls. Now, why I am saying all this? See, my purpose is to help you at your personal level, whatever the conditions are outside. If you do not have any control over those, at least you can keep yourself in peace, in good shape. That is the purpose of my creating this video today, that wherever you are, whatever you are doing, try to have a peaceful mind. See, nobody is able to keep his or her mind peaceful, tranquil all the time. If you are living in this world, you have to face a lot of things at home as well as outside. But try to be peaceful most of the time, because agitated mind, disturbed mind can affect very badly to the physical health of a person, because it is, don't forget, it is mind over matter, right? If your mind is tranquil, you are at peace, then you are bound to have good health. And even if you are suffering from some physical ailment, a peaceful mind will help you a lot to bear the pain and suffering, right? Now what you can do? See, our rishis, the great sages, they realized long time ago that one's mind should be tranquil, peaceful. You must have heard about the Yoga Sutras of the great Maharishi Patanjali. The treatise, Patanjali Yoga Sutras, is a great treatise, and it gives us practical knowledge which you can utilize in your daily life. The second verse or sutra, the second sutra of Patanjali's Yoga Sutras says, defines yoga, yogas chit vritti nirodha, right? Now what is yoga? Yoga means uniting your limited self with your true self. That is possible only when there is cessation of the modifications of the mind. What is meant by modifications of the mind? See, all the time there is a whirlpool of thoughts and related emotions, mostly to your experiences in the past or if you are going through a bad time at present. Mostly you are disturbed by the negative thoughts, whatever happened with you or whatever is happening with you. And then when a thought comes, you undergo the related feelings, which are not good. Bad thoughts have bad memories and bad emotions. That affects your physical health. And if your mind is not tranquil, you are unable to give your full potential in whatever work you are doing, right? So your mind has to be at rest, and cessation, as per this sutra, cessation of the modifications of the mind, right? In short, in a nutshell, it simply means calming down your mind. See, your thoughts, emotions, all they are related to either your body or mind, right? Which includes your intellect, your ego, and your lower mind. And in Sanskrit, this is called chitta or antakaran, right? Now the question is, how you can calm down your mind? See, this inability to calm down your mind, it is difficult, of course. And even Lord Krishna agrees to it. In Bhagavad Gita, there is a verse number 35 of 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Lord Krishna, when he was giving instructions to Arjuna, he says, असंशयम महाबाहो मनो दुर्निग्रह चलम अभ्यासे ना तू कौंत्या वैरागन च गृहते. What does it mean? Lord Krishna says, undoubtedly the mind is fickle and unruly, but by practice and by dispassion, Arjuna, the mind may nevertheless be controlled. So Lord Krishna agrees, yes, mind is fickle and unruly, of course it is, right? But it can be brought under control. How? Lord Krishna suggests two ways, by practice and by dispassion. Now let us see, what does he mean by practice? There are so many techniques, and I have made videos also. You sit down calmly in a comfortable posture, close your eyes, and then focus your attention on your breath. You are not to control your breath, you are not to change your breathing pattern, whatever it is, breathe normally. But just focus your attention on your breath, whether you are inhaling or you are exhaling. Because see, the mind has to be engaged somewhere, otherwise it will go wild. So this is a practice. If you do this practice, then see, practice makes a man perfect. You can gradually be able to become a master of your mind, and your mind will be your slave. So by practice, there are so many methods, so many ways. So one, I am telling you, sit down calmly, spend 10 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, depends how much time you can spare, and focus on your breath. So mind will be engaged somewhere. So for that period, for this session, at least your mind will be free from unruly thoughts, thoughts, unwanted thoughts. If any thought comes at that time to your mind, just push it aside. Go away. I've been asked to focus on my breath. Right? So with practice, you will be able to. Then there are many other yogic techniques also. I made a video. There is a Hong Sa technique, very ancient technique, very useful. And that technique will help you to calm down your mind, will also improve your concentration. I made a video on that. You can do that. So if you practice using any of these techniques 2-3 times a day, gradually it will become a habit of your mind to be in a tranquil state. Right? So by practice, this is what Lord Krishna means, using many yogic techniques and doing it. And there is another technique which you can find many videos on YouTube also, Yoga Nidra. That also helps. Yes. Mindfulness techniques, they do help. Right? Then the second method Lord Krishna is suggesting to Arjuna is how, what is that? Dispassion. What does it mean? Dispassion. Now you will find in many interpretations of Bhagavad Gita in Sanskrit, they say Vairagya. Now Vairagya here doesn't mean that you have to give up everything, you have to go away from the world, no. Or you have to retire somewhere and not be engaged in worldly matters, no. Vairagya here means that you try to be a stern instructor. Sit down somewhere. If a negative thought comes, forcibly replace it by a positive thought. Right? So try to control your mind and let not your emotions come in between. That is what it is meant by dispassion. Let not your emotions prevent you from controlling your mind. Be a stern instructor. Be a master. And consider your mind your slave. Right? So forcibly you can do that. Sit somewhere in a comfortable posture and say, for this period of 10 minutes or 15 minutes, I will not entertain any thoughts, especially negative thoughts in my mind. And I will focus my mind on any idea which I think is appropriate, a positive idea or positive thought. That is what is meant here by dispassion. Right? So you can do, you can control. And if you sit, if you do this, you see, when you will find that you are relaxed, your mind is tranquil, it is a sort of ecstasy. Enjoy that. It's a great thing. And it is going to bring transformation in your life gradually. Right? And then you will be able to bear all the difficulties through which you are passing. Right? There may be anything troubling you. If not related to your own self, it could be because of the circumstances outside. You will be able to cope very well. Right? It will give you great inner strength. So try to follow these things. Try to be tranquil most of the time. It will increase your efficiency in whatever work you are doing. I hope this video will help you and it will bring greater peace, happiness and health in your life. Thank you for watching.